terrible, Heidrich.
Now we have fought many fights and we want to break through to the international top toward winning titles. Your goal is to be a champion in your weight category. You'll have to do a lot to achieve this, and remember, you are not the only one. There are many who have this ambitious goal. So the point is to be better than the rest. This doesn't mean that you have to be stronger than your opponent, because there are many ways to outclass your opponent and be better than the rest. Most fighters are already stagnant with a certain fighting style or their strongest points, and think that's going to be enough. Fighters like this become too predictable. Just be unpredictable and have a large range of techniques in your repertoire. Also, it's important to analyze yourself so you can see what your weak points and strong points are and correct and improve those points. In my case, I had good strong kicking techniques at the beginning of my career. So I started to add an extra boxing training, and after a while my hands started becoming strong weapons. If you know how to combine these two disciplines, kicking and boxing, you'll become a dangerous fighter because you'll have a knockout strike in your hands as well as in your legs. Plus, you create openings with your hands and vice versa.
My trainer, Andre Manard, is holding the pads for me. I start with 20 punches, 10 left straight forward and 10 backwards, for the distance and conditioning the arms. After this, I'll start with a 1-2-4 punch combination on my trainer's count. He started with the left and straight forward. By the count of 2, I'm giving the left and right straight forward and a left body punch. Count 3, we're at it after the body punch a left hook. By the last count, we're again with the left right straight forwards, the left body punch, a left hook to finish with a right straight punch. Watch how I turn in the body while giving the liver punch. You can see, while keeping my balance in the center, my punches are powerful. It's important that the trainer, during the punching, is also pushing the pads a little bit forwards. This gives a good impact while hitting the pads. You can see my trainer is in constantly control. If I make mistakes, he corrects me. The important things are the footwork, distance, timing and the power. Watch how Andre is pushing the pads a little bit forwards. Again, this gives a good impact while punching. My trainer Andre is checking my defense with counter punches and leg kicks. He also looks if I'm in balance for a block and counters. I make sure I make enough steps with my combination to keep distance and balance. Again, with every count, there is a punch added to the combination. Watch how I hold my arms. This is to measure the distance. We're showing the last part of the second round. We start again with the 20 left and right punches. Then I make a new combination in 4 steps. Again, by the first count we're starting with the left jab. The second count we're editing an uppercut. By count 3 we're finishing with the left hook. And with the fourth count with the right straight punch. You can see that after every punch or combination I step back to the fighting distance. So I move in and out. This is important to measure the reach as well for my trainer as for myself. You can see my trainer Andre is checking me constantly. It's important that Andre is checking me to see if I stay alert at all times. I'm finishing the round with single power punches. Again, I move backwards on a count. I step in with a left jab and a right punch. Now you can see I step backwards and finishing with the right punch. I am starting with the 20 punches again, then the new combination in 4 steps. The first count, we start with a right punch. The second count, we start with a right punch and a left uppercut. In the third count, we're adding a right straight punch to our combination. The last count will show the right punch, the left uppercut, the right punch, and the left liver punch. I have a certain rhythm in every combination. This is bang, bang, 1 second rest, and bang, the body punch. With my body punch, I lower my body by bend my knees, but such that I stay in balance and step back to the basic position. Here we can listen to the rhythm from the punches on the pads. Again, you can hear the rhythm of the punches on the pads. Thank you. We start the fourth round with 30 left-right punches. Now forwards and backwards, so 3 times 10. After that, I counter with punches, on a right leg kick and a left high kick. My trainer Andre is the one who makes me fight forwards or backwards, by going forward or backwards. Andre attacks me with a right leg kick. I block and counter with a right punch. The second attack is a left high kick. I block with two hands and counter with a left hook. After this, I counter with a double punch. You can see, now I block, counter with a right punch and a left hook. With the high kick, I make a left hook and a right punch. I turn my body in every punch to have a lot of power in my punches. After this combination, I make an extra kick, so the punches stay the same, but I follow up with a right leg kick and a left body kick. We're finishing a round with single power punches. A right punch and a left hook on every count. You can see Andre is keeping the pressure on me, and sometimes he let me come forward. It's like an opponent, sometimes he backs you up, and sometimes you go after him. But with single punches, you stand in good balance, and not move too much, but put power in your punches to finish. And we're finishing the round with a single power punches, a right punch and a left hook on every count. Now I start with the kicks. I start to get my distance and timing with push kicks and a body kick. And later I counter on front kicks with body kicks. Notice my little step in between while I'm kicking the pads. Now Andre attacks with front kicks and I redirect them and counter with a left body kick and later right kicks. After I redirect, I make a step in between to get in the right position to give a powerful kick. You can see I turn my whole body in the kick and be ready for every counter after my kick. You can see that after I redirect the attacking leg, my opponent gets off balance, which creates an ideal opening to give a counter kick. You can see that by moving your whole body behind the kick can be very powerful. This is the finishing power we need in a real fight. Also with the kick counters, I move in and out, and be sure that I redirect the kick good before I counter. Now we take the big pad for the kicks, for the better impact. I start again with a push kick and a body kick for 30 seconds. After the first 30 seconds, we start with counter kicks on the leg kick and on the high kicks. Now my trainer Andre is attacking me with a right leg kick. I block, make a step in between and counter with a left body kick. We do the same with the left high kick. I block and counter with the left body kick. By kicking with the shin on the pad, you can see it gives a lot of impact. Notice the double-handed block as we learned. After this, we counter with the right kick. After blocking the right low kick, I'm countering with a left kick to the body. You can see, with my right kick, I take a good step with my left leg sidewards, forwards, to get the right distance, and power in my kick, and step back to the basic position. First part of the round, I make counter kicks on the left jab, and later on the right punch, with leg kicks. That's how the trainer is building up the speed. I block the left punch and come in with the left body kick. Again, you can see that I kick with my shin for a good impact. Turn your body while kicking is very important to kick powerful. Here I made total sparring with a big bag, but start with push and body kicks. Then I spar for 1 minute with the pad. After this I make a right punch, left kick combination and follow with a left jab and a right leg kick. While sparring, I try to do everything fluid and not only with power. You can see how Andre has to push me to the last 3 minutes of this round. Now the exercise starts with a left jab, where I follow with a right kick to the legs. These shots you saw of the pad training are just parts of every round. That's why sometimes I still tell something what's not shown. But the whole schedule is in the beginning. Now after 30 seconds rest, we start with the last 20 power kicks. After the second 30 seconds of sparring, I make hard right punches as Andre steps in and finish with some high kicks. Now we start with the last part of the training, the 20 power kicks. We'll practice this 20 times left and 20 times right. Watch how I kick with my shin bone. You see, I step in every kick I make and put my whole body in it. While I kick, I watch my defense. My explosion of the kick is in the step to the pad and only in my leg. The quicker I turn my body, the more explosion is in my kick. After the kicking, André clocks my heartbeat for 1 minute. It's around 168. And after 1 minute, it went down to 128. So that's all right. In good shape, it will go down to about 40 to 45 heartbeats in 1 minute. This is more a complete form of training on the pads for Muay Thai. Bob Schreier, my partner, holds the pads. Bob attacks with a right leg kick. I block and counter with a right punch, a left hook, plus a right leg kick. After the action, I'll step back in the basic position. I'll stop Bob off while he wants to come forward with a left body kick. So he wants to come forward and I'll stop him off with a left body kick. After the left hook, I step sidewards, in for the right leg kick. I don't step straight forwards. I'm making the same block and counter punches and leg kicks, but now I step back and make a step in between and come back with a left body kick. After I step back, I step with the kick again forward to put my body in the kick. Here we can see I'm making counters on a high kick with a punch and a left kick. Bob attacks with a left high kick. I block double-handed and I counter with a right punch and a left body kick. I put my body in the punch and step in between and put my body in the kick too. With the second counter, I make a punch combination, step in between and kick left to the body. I block the high kick and counter with a right punch, left uppercut and a right punch. Then I make distance with the step in between for the left kick. Bob attacks with a left front kick, I redirect with left and making the same move with the left hook and step in with a right body kick. With the second counter, I redirect the same, but counter with a left hook, a right punch and a left hook. I'll step in with my left leg to the side and kick right to the body. By stepping sideways, I can put my whole body in the kick. I make sure I redirect the front kick good before I counter, otherwise the counter is no good. I make distance so my opponent thinks he can attack me. On that moment, I counter. Pop is attacking me now with a right high kick. I block double-handed and counter with a left hook. Step in with a right knee. Now I'm countering with three punches after the block. A left hook, a right punch and a left hook. I'll step in with the right knee. The punches are fast and powerful, and I'll put my body in the knee by pulling my hips in it. I make sure that the block is double-handed, because if the kick comes through, I can't counter. After every combination, I step back and make space to step in with a right body kick. Bob is coming in, and I stop him with a front push kick and a knee, if he comes in again. Now I make the knees forward from a moving position. In the beginning we do this on a count, later we do this in tempo. When I grab Bob around the neck, I stand close to him, and when I make the knee, I step back and make distance and fire back. The same thing happens in tempo. Now we're practicing the exercise in tempo. You see that after every knee I make distance again, to oversee everything and to step in again. I'm keeping my defense while giving the knees. You can see it's very tough for Bob who's holding the pads, so I aim good with my knees and kicks. If you don't aim too good, he will get hurt. In the clinch, I close up after every knee and step back for the next one. And again in tempo. This training is for the timing and power in the leg kicks. This is the only way to train the leg kick on full power on a moving opponent. Bob is holding the pads for his left leg and steps towards to me. On that moment I also step sideways forwards and make a right leg kick. With the leg kick, I turn in my body and hips and kick with the shin. Believe me, this is very powerful. Watch the impact when my shin is hitting the pad. You can see Bob is having fun in holding the pads and wants to continue. The same I also do on the back leg. Bob holds the pad on his front leg, and when he steps in, I'll catch him with the low kick. When Bob makes the step, I make a step in between and make a left leg kick on the back leg. I kick a little downwards to have a good impact after every kick. I step back and move and wait for Bob to step in again. Hardening the shins is very important. You need an old truck tire which doesn't have any profile left. You put the tire against the wall. You can see Bob kicks with his shin to the side of the tire. Start slowly and do this 3 times a week. It will hurt in the beginning. What I just did on the big pad with the leg kicks, I do now with my partner, just for timing, so not with full power. My partner attacks with a left jab. When he steps in, I step to make a right leg kick. It's an important exercise for your timing. The same I do with a body kick, but hold my kick in because there's no protection.
sait, il a mûri, il a pris son temps. Et c'est véritablement une consécration pour lui que de se retrouver face.
Here you see some actions. I'm anticipating with kicks.
C'est véritablement une consécration pour lui que de...
It's nice to see the timing where I follow up with the inside leg kick. You can see that my kick is so powerful that I kick him off balance. I take a little step backwards with an attacking fighter. As soon as he's throwing in a kick, I counter kick with a right inside leg kick. I interrupt here some kicks with punches. My partner attacks with a right high kick. I counter punch with a right punch. Now my partner attacking me with a left kick and I counter punch with the left hook. The timing is very important. If I'm too early, he sees it. If I'm too late, I get hit. When giving the left hook, I keep my right arm high for security, next to my head. So, if I am too late, I still have one hand on the right place.
Il suit les conseils qu'on lui a donnés. Ne pas rentrer dans la garde de Luc Ferreil, car c'est à mi-distance qu'il est dangereux.
Et encore un contre du gauche. Oh,
il était terrible ce crochet du gauche. Vous avez vu l'effet à retardement.
Here we can see some interruptions with a punch, and the attack is a kick. It's all about a good timing.
Ne pas rentrer dans la garde de Luc Ferreil, car c'est à mi-distance qu'il est dangereux.
Et encore un contre du gauche. Oh,
My opponent attacks me with a right leg kick. I interrupt by stepping a little bit forward and giving a counterpunch by giving a left hook. Trying out the opponent is very important. It's very important to try out your opponent if you know nothing about your opponent. You have to try to find out what kind of fighter he is. Point is, you want to find out what his strong points are. This can be found out by faking a lot and irritate him, so he wants to attack, but be aware for every counter if you irritate him. Again, keep an eye contact with your opponent and try to move out the corner. We're exercising this, not on full power, but on speed and fluidness. I irritate him with easy things like jabs and inside leg kicks. Don't make too difficult combinations, that's only a big risk. Stick with one or two punches or a kick. Also, we fake once in a while to see his reaction. Remember, don't make the combinations too difficult. Just make one punch or one kick. This is just why you want him to show something. Let's see how this applies in a fight. Here you can see I'm testing out my opponent. Watch how I'm testing my opponent. I'm moving and faking a lot to irritate him. Stay alert at all times when irritating in the beginning of a fight your opponent. Thank you. how to deal with an attacking fighter. Here I show how to deal with an attacking fighter. You look first and I will explain later. I try to keep my opponent on distance with short combinations and follow up with leg kicks. I turn away and don't let him put me in the ropes. While turning away, I kick his legs. He has to recover and get in the right position again. You can see how I turn away of the corner and place him in the ropes and have a possibility to counter. By giving short combinations and following up with the leg kick, we control the distance. You can see I'm moving to the ring. I'm moving sidewards to the left and to the right. But I'll keep my opponent busy. Another possibility is while giving him the feeling he can come in and keep him away with a push kick and a front knee and hard body kicks. Turn away and counter.
façon. Il va se précipiter sur Kaman pour essayer de conclure.
Here I show how to deal with an attacking fighter. Try to move backwards and sidewards and try to counter.
Il va se précipiter sur Kaman pour essayer de conclure. Il replace encore une droite.
You can see I turn away while he wants to put me in the ropes.
Le paquet, comme on dit. Et il a raison.
Watch how my left jab is stopping him off.
Le paquet, comme on dit. Et il a raison. Avec les pieds, tellement les deux boxeurs veulent faire la décision quasiment sur un coup. Superbe droite plongeante.
By moving backwards and keeping my balance in the center, I give a good counter punch with my right hand.
Décision quasiment sur un coup. Superbe droite plongeante.
He's not only a boxing type of fighter, he can take a punch too.
Deux mains derrière avec l'œil droit de Ferrer qui se ferme petit à petit. Et toute la chance de Kaman maintenant réside dans son travail de jambes avec une garde bien fermée, hermétique.
Again, the left jab. Beware of the counter, as you can see. And a push kick when he's moving forward to keep the right distance.
Les deux mains derrière avec l'œil droit de Ferrer qui se ferme petit à petit. Et toute la chance de Kaman maintenant réside dans son travail de jambes avec une garde bien fermée, hermétique.
Watch how my first punch take away his sides and I'm following up with the right uppercut. Dealing with a boxing type of fighter. When I deal with a boxing type of fighter, I try to do like I show here with my partner. In slow motion, He'll try to show you how to handle a boxing type of fighter. A puncher needs to come close and needs a good balance. So I keep him busy with flurry punches. And when he comes in my reach, I grab him, turn him in the ropes and counter on his legs. Again, you grab in and you counter and end up with a leg kick. The punches I make are not so hard, but he has to block them, and when he wants to punch, he's in my reach. You can see, I grabbed him, turned him on the ropes and counter on his legs. When he's in my range, I grab him good and turn him right away in the ropes. Don't wait too long, he's able to punch, and I'll follow up with punches and a leg kick.
Voilà, bonne droite du Polonais. changement de tactique chez l'Hollandais qui se sert maintenant de sa...
I'm showing you how to deal with a boxing fighter. But in real, it's not as easy as within training. You get hit for real. But still, you have to move and turn away and counter. That's what I try here to do. You can see, by stepping backwards and reviewing the situation, I can counterpunch and I stay in eye contact with my opponent.
Voilà, bonne droite du Polonais.
Et changement de tactique chez le Hollandais qui se sert maintenant de sa jambe arrière gauche.
By way of pushing your opponent and stepping back in the basic position, you can review the situation. This is important with the boxing type of fighter. Dealing with a static fighter. If your opponent is a static fighter, so he moves so much, you have to move around him and irritate him as much as possible. By irritating him, he will take action. So I move around him and irritate him a lot with quick punches and kicks, inside leg kicks and jabs to the face, so he gets a little bit angry. While irritating him and making a lot of points, he has to do something back. So be aware when he does. Especially when your opponent gets angry, he starts making mistakes. He don't think so good and makes mistakes. But be always aware for attacks. And if he attacks, you have to be sure your counters are hard and effective. While irritating my opponent, I'm making a lot of points. Of course, in a real fight, this will give me a good advantage in one round on points. So maybe in the later rounds, he has to force the fight because he's behind on points. When your opponent has to force the fight, make sure your counters are hard and effective. Here you can see how I deal with a static TIE fighter. I irritate him and wait for his attack. You can see I start to irritate my opponent while giving a left inside low kick. I move around and I make him nervous. And I'm faking. Watch now, I block his kick and counter with a right low kick. If you are a tall fighter, it's no use to be attacking all the time. You have to use your reach and fight on a distance. I keep my opponent on a distance, with front kicks, jabs, leg kicks and front knees, and move sidewards. When he comes in my reach, I grab him and don't let him go anymore. This part I cannot show anymore, because there was a little accident. A left high kick to the head hits my partner. But to keep your opponent on distance, it's important that he's gonna take more risk to get in on you. And from these mistakes you have to take advantage. The part, what I can't show you anymore, is that when my partner is in my reach, I grab him and hit him with knee and don't let him go. We saw this little accident happen. Of course the producer immediately told Rob's partner that he should drop his defense again and repeat his action. Unfortunately, he wouldn't listen. Here, I try to imitate a short fighter. A short fighter always have to move in and have to take risks. A short fighter has to move a lot and be a busy fighter. He has to make a lot of combinations with his hands and follow with leg kicks and body kicks. You see that the short fighter has to move in and has to take risks. Short fighter has to move in and out and fake a lot to find and create openings in the defense. Also, backing up your opponent and put him in the ropes is important. Try to force him to fight in your rhythm, and don't let him come in his own rhythm. Sparring with boxing is to get rhythm and timing and distance. It's good for your balance and develop your combination ability, if you do it right. Sparring is not standing toe to toe, and try to hit each other as hard as you can. If that's what you thought, you have the wrong idea of sparring. It's giving each other the possibility to try something new, a combination or footwork. So we're trying out evasion, combination, footwork, slips, but we do it relaxed. Later, if everything goes well, you can put more pressure and power, but it's still sparring and not a real fight. So the main reason we spar is to get rhythm, timing and distance. It's good to develop your combination ability if you do it right. Watch how I keep eye contact with my opponent. It'll help me and keep me in advantage by counter punching. Watch again how I keep my balance in the center and I move around my opponent by taking little steps to the side. You can hear that the punches are relaxed, it's not a big bang. It was relaxed by sparring and we don't hit each other to hurt each other. Try out everything, not only come forward and throw in your punches, but evade and fake as well.
Thank you.
The clinching I train always at the end of the training. I start with grabbing each other around the neck and try to get your arms to the inside and pull your opponent off balance with short pulls on his neck and step sidewards. So you try to pull your opponent off balance. By giving short jerks, you will be off balance. I try always to stand up, straight up. Don't let your opponent pull you down. Don't use too much power during clinching. It's a lot of techniques. It's not only power. Use the power of your opponent at that point. Just take a look how we're clinching. Thank you. Total sparring is like boxing sparring, for timing, distance and combination of footwork, and not to hurt each other. Move forwards and backwards and try to do everything that's possible. You can do it. The more you try, the more you will do in the ring. Try out every combination, clinch and footwork, the more experience you get. You'll start to recognize also more things from your opponent. The way how he fights, moves and attacks. A good fighter can adapt to every fighting style, so try to fight like all fighters, long, tall, static and boxing type. This kind of sparring is not to hurt each other. Again, it's for timing, distance, combination and footwork. It's nice to try out your footwork, clinching and combinations to get more experience in fighting. Notice that it's only possible when you are relaxed and your partner as well. Again, notice that a good fighter can adapt to every fighting style, so try to fight like all fighters, long, tall, static or a boxing type. A good fighter is an all-round fighter. Everything we learned we can put in the sparring, the redirect, fake, takeovers, clinching, whatever we would like. Remember, a good fighter is an all-round fighter. this tape, I show you which training methods you can use to prepare you for a fight. Try to pick out the things which you feel will work for you and your fighting career. Good luck and have fun.